the 2018 version of the University of Rio Grande Symphonic Band. As you can tell, we've got members of the community. We have talented high school people sitting in with us. We have music majors and non-music majors. So if you are out there and play an instrument, I'll be after you. I'll make a deal with you. There's no audition for this group. So we practice one night a week on Thursdays, and you're more than welcome to join us. Even if you don't have an instrument, we can find an instrument. So I'd like to build this 51, 52 members up to 100 if we could, and fill the whole stage. We're having a good time up here, if you don't notice. During the very first tune, the Aces of the Air March, it's a tune where everyone gets warmed up because no one sits and rests for a bunch of majors. Everyone gets to play right from the very beginning. This is called Aces of the Air. Concert. We do everything from a little multicultural to some semi-classical pieces by Vivaldi. Ragtime, even visit the Beatles before we're finished today. So the second tune we're going to play is called Children of the Sun. It's actually about an area of southeastern Peru where they worship the sun. It's called Children of the Sun, and an arranger came along, made this arrangement called Children of a Different Sun. We'll be right back.
among the many adult members that's been with this group since its inception, actually, these two young ladies over here have been my loyal standby people that I can always rely on to be here for every concert for several years, all the 17 that I've been here. Looking for a flute piccolo duet, I came across a piece that we're used to doing on trumpet. It's called a trumpet concerto, Vivaldi trumpet concerto. Well, this piece was listed as a double concerto, and I found out we could do it with woodwinds, two saxes, two clarinets, two flutes. So this is my perfect opportunity to feature Kenny Horton, Vicki Sheets, on a piece called Double Concerto by Vivaldi. These ladies deserve more than just a bouquet of flowers. I've been at this for several years. Next piece is a ragtime piece. And if any of my students are out there from music appreciation class, we study Tin Pan Alley music and the music Scott Joplin, several of those people, right at the turn of the century up to about 1930. They called it ragtime music because of the ragged, syncopated rhythms. Scott Joplin had a famous tune called The Entertainer. Some of you might remember that. This reminded me of that as soon as I heard it. And so we decided to do the black and the white rag. And you'll notice these people, if they have time to smile at you, they enjoy this piece. This is a fun piece. Catching our breath after that black and white rag. I'd like for all the music educators on stage to please stand up just a minute. We do this every concert. We'd like to recognize these people because they have a very busy spring. Some of them walked in my rehearsal back there about 5 minutes before we came out here because they've been at rehearsals or going all day long. Give these people a big hand, please. Okay, the word got out we were going to feature two flute players, two flautists. So the percussion section had to have their day in the sun. So this is a concerto for percussion with band accompaniment. So if you've always wanted to be a drummer, now's your chance to enjoy the drummer, the percussion section. Thank you. Okay, before I introduce this next gentleman, needless to say, we go back a long way, been each other several years. And as far as the history of the university's symphonic band, I'll let Dave tell you about that in just a minute. I can say this, Dave. We've only had three directors, right, ladies? Three directors since Dave started the group. One year, I believe it was 2000, and Mr. Dave Baer. And I've been here as either as an adjunct or full-time since 2001. So this is great to see this much participation. And this is Mr. Dave Phelps.
Deja vu all over again, I guess we could call it. Exactly 30 years ago, my phone rang at my home in Galt Place. I was teaching at Galt Academy High School then. And a friend of mine named Paul Lloyd, who was dean of the College of Education, said, "We'd like to have you come out and start a symphony band and pep band at Rye Grand." And of course I said, "Absolutely, I'll give it a shot." So they gave me $50,000, a lease purchase program to buy our basic needs, not half the instruments you see here, but enough to get going and get started. I was here for 11 years, as Mr. Stewart mentioned, another director, and Gary's been here a long time too. But it's gratifying for me, first of all, to be able to conduct this band tonight. After we did start this thing, it seemed like yesterday's been 30 years ago. I know it looks like it on me. It's been 30 years ago. But it's good to see all these students here, high school students, all my fellow music educators, my college friends. And also, not giving any names away, but the ones who were here with me 30 years ago in this band. I'm going to try something. If you were in my first band 30 years ago, would you please stand? Give me a hand, please. You notice one looks just like me over here on this side. That's my friend, Brother Tom. So we kind of stuck it out together. So it's, well, thank Mr. Gary Stewart for letting me come back and conduct. It's a great thrill for me. We've got a good piece for you. This is about our great country, America. We can picture some of the landscapes and scenery, some of the things out west, but also the mighty power we've had, the respect as a nation we've had all these years. It's called American Jubilee. It's my pleasure to conduct it. I hope you enjoy it. American Jubilee. Thank you.
I always make comments to my classes. Getting back to music appreciation, just because you're here tonight, I'm going to tell you one of the test questions on the next test here in 2 weeks. When did the British invasion hit the United States? Anyone? 1964. Remember that Ed Sullivan TV show, and they appeared on there? But a lot of British groups hit the United States, but there's some recent books out about how the music of the Beatles kind of revolutionized American music. There are several, if you can read your program, now we turn the lights down, there are several different tunes in this medley, and it all kind of builds up to my favorite, a thing called Something in the Way You Smile at the end of it. So I hope you enjoy it, and even some of these people sitting behind me said, Emily, that this was your first, Abbey Road was her first album that she wore out, belonged to her father, and she completely wore it out. Here we go, Abbey Road, a symphonic portrait.
Thank you.
as much as I did, because it's fun to stand up here and direct great musicians, right, Dave?
Yes, sir.
It's fun to be in our spot. Our next concert will be in the fall, so please look out for that. Now, I was serious the way I introduced the concert. If you do play an instrument, you'd like to join us, no auditions necessary. Get in contact with me through the music department, my email. We appreciate you being here tonight. Thank you very much.